All right, so we're going to take a look at some problems that may or may not involve systems of equations. Now, the difference in these problems, as opposed to the problems we've seen before, is that there are no equations. And so we have to generate the equations ourselves first. So let's take a look at our first problem. Don't walk too far away from the microphone cord or else your microphone gets popped out. That's exactly what it says. All right, so I'm going to be looking at the evens because you are charged with getting the answers for the odds. So I'm going to give myself a little blank space to write your name. One number is 4 less than 11 times another. The sum of the two numbers is 92. Find the numbers. So we're going to take each sentence by themselves and try to write an equation out of this. One number is. Well, is means equals. So I can go ahead and write an equal sign. And do I know what this number is? No. Let's call it n. So a number is 4 less, that means minus 4, than 11 times. 11 times another. How about O? No, how about P? I don't want to do O because then it looked like 110. So then it goes on to say the sum, so that is adding, of these two numbers, so that means N plus P is, there's my is again, equals 92. All right. Now I can do this one of two ways. If I have two standard form expressions, I am going to use the elimination method, multiplication and addition. If I have one in slope-intercept and one in standard, then I'm going to use substitution. It's just easier. I want to do as little work as possible. And this, I already know that n is equal to 11p minus 4. So instead of n, what can I write? I can write 11 p minus 4 plus, here's my plus p, and that is all equal to 92. All right, well, if I have 11p, add one more, that makes 12p minus 4 is equal to 92, plus 4 plus 4, and I get 12p is equal to 96. That's pretty good because I know 96 is divisible by 12. 96 divided by 12. And that's 8. So P is equal to 8. So then, all right, so then let's plug in P, all right, 8. So we have N plus 8 is equal to 92. Well, that makes this 84, because if I subtract, so N is equal to 84. And hopefully those are my two numbers. I love it. It is. Spoiler alert. All right, so let's take a look at number 4. Marsha. Is anyone a fan of the Brady Bunch?
No.
Nope, no fans of the Brady.
Not a fan.
Not a fan.
Not a fan of
that
voice
either. Well. Not because if you can't embarrass your children, then what fun would be is there being a parent? So.
Yeah, don't have kids.
There you go. Marsha has $84 less. So Marsha has $84 less. So that's minus 84, three times as much as Sue. Three times as much as Sue. Together, they have $132. So together, that means M plus S is equal to 132. And again, if I have two standard form expressions, I am going to use the elimination method. If I have one slope-intercept and one standard, I'm going to use substitution because it's easier and I like easier. So M is equal to, okay, so we have 3S minus 84 plus S is equal to 132. All right, so now 3S plus S, that's 4S. Minus my 84 is equal to 132 plus 84, because that's the opposite of subtracting 84. And that's going to be equal to 4s is equal to, calculator, 132 minus 84. Oh, that's just 48. Divide it by 4, and I get 12. And again, that gives us s is equal to 12. So that means Sue has $12. But we gotta find out what Marsha has. So if Marsha has $12, well, something plus 12 is 132. Well, 120, right? 120 is worth. Hold on a second. What? This is A3. All right. Oh, shoot. My goodness, I forgot to add. It's nothing worse than making a mistake on a video after you've put in like 10 minutes, because you don't want to redo it, right? Yeah, haha, laugh it up. So, we have 132 plus 84, and I get 216, because I was getting an answer that just did not seem right to me whatsoever. And so then we have 4s divided by 4, divided by 4, divided by 4, and I get 54. Now that's starting to look a little bit better. So Sue has $54. And so let's plug that in. So then plug that in for here, so I get m plus 54 is equal to 132 minus 54 minus 54. And I get m is equal to 132 minus 54. I get 78. Now that makes more sense. Now, it's not a bad thing that I made that silly error. Here's the thing. Clearly, I knew that the answer was not right. And so what caused me to know it wasn't right? Well, when I had a number here and I plugged in, I got a value for Marsha that would make this one not make sense. It just didn't make sense. So that told me I had to go back and check my work. And luckily, since I had all my work written out, I could see that I forgot to say this was adding and I added a subtracting. So that's kind of a nice little thing to show how to go through. And, you know, always think about, did your answer make sense?